The second machine age is a huge opportunity, but also challenge for CXOs of all levels, especially CIOs. If they're smart, they should be leading this challenge and helping their other executives in the organization understand the profound implications of the technology. But it goes well beyond what's happening inside the IT shop, the 2 or 4 or 6% of the budget that's devoted to IT. It's really transforming the whole rest of the organization. And if they're smart, their supply chain, the way they interact with their customers, the whole ecosystem. And that requires cooperation from the marketing folks, from the finance folks, from the supply chain and operations folks. Each of these areas has to be reinvented. Every industry needs to be rethought from the ground up. CIOs can be the leaders of that because they understand the technology, and the good ones also understand the customer needs and the business processes that need to be transformed. That kind of business process innovation is a lot harder. It's a lot less visible than the technology innovation, but it's where the smart CIOs are putting more and more of their energy. People in the C-suite need to recognize that the job of computerization involves much, much more than simply buying pieces of hardware or even software. Most of it is in the rethinking of opportunities, finding new ways to reach your customers, work with your suppliers, coordinate your workers, rethink your business processes, imagine new products, new services. The creativity is almost limitless in terms of what potentially could be done, and we see winning companies as the ones that embrace these new technologies to do new things. When I did my earlier research in the 90s, I could find that there's a pretty strong correlation between more IT investment and better business performance. More recently, it's gotten more complicated. It's not simply a matter of spending more money. It's a matter of embracing a technology-oriented mindset. And there are situations where you use cloud computing or use other technologies that you don't need to spend more money to get better performance. Having a CEO, a leader, who understands that every company today is a technology company, and they have to be in close discussion with their CIOs or CTOs or whatever titles they give them, and their marketing folks, their operations folks, all have to have a mindset of how can we use technology to transform our core functions. These are very exciting times for CIOs, or some people maybe use the Chinese curse, these are interesting times. In our research, we found that there's more turbulence now than ever before, and the potential to win and win big is greater than it was before. We're seeing more winner-take-all markets, but we're also seeing companies are being much less stable in their positions, their relative industry positions. It's not as easy to sit on your laurels to have the leading position and assume that you're going to be able to stay there for 5 or 10 or 20 years. Now, it's quite possible that some new company that you've never heard of will come out of nowhere and very quickly grab a piece of your market, or you suddenly realize that your market is different than what you thought it was. So this requires a much more nimble kind of mindset, one that understands both technology and customers.